Okay, well, everything is in place. Everyone is ready. Some people just wish we were half an hour further in, and but God is here, and it's wonderful. It's great to have family and friends from around the world, and all of us here as well. So the stage is set. God is here to marry Leighton and Andrea, and we are witnesses, and it's wonderful. So now it's just waiting as people arrive. We're not waiting for the electronics anymore. And just to let you know, it is going to be an acoustic affair, not a projected sound and stuff. So if, Ray, I'm relying on you, if you can't hear what's going on back up here, let us know, okay?
In our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend, and I'll help you carry on, for it won't be alone. I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Somebody planned it all. I feel right where I belong.
Let's stand for the bride.
Party's gone. lights. Oh, no, we don't have much. Sure feels like a lot. So take my heart, take my hand. Take my heart, take my hand. Take my heart, take my hand. Right where we stand.
You may be seated. Everyone else may be seated. Yes. Marriage. The bond and covenant of marriage between one man and one woman is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity, and for the creation and nurturing of children in the knowledge and love of God. This was established by God in creation. And so Leighton and Andrea are not entering this state of marriage lightly or unadvisedly, but reverently, deliberately, advisedly, and in the fear of God, in accordance with the purposes for which He instituted it. Marriage established by God, and of course involving a couple. Today, Leighton and Andrea, with great excitement, they have reached this point. Here is how one man describes the excitement and content of this coming together of Leighton and Andrea.
This at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and his mother and hold fast to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. This mystery is profound. And I am saying that it refers to Christ and the church. You know what? When we see that, when that becomes a revelation in our hearts, how we treat one another will change for the good.
Many of us will have recognized the much loved voice. That was Leighton's grandfather, Barney Coombs. I'm especially saying that for those of you who are joining us online. You might not know that voice, but the voice of Barney, grandfather who would have rejoiced in this day. And I expect he is from where he is. Leighton. Repeat after me and try and lift up your voice. There's no sound, and these guys on online want to hear. The guys here will hear. But Leighton, repeat after me. I solemnly declare.
I solemnly declare.
That I do not know.
That I do not know.
Of any lawful impediment.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Leighton Barnabas Coombs.
Why I, Leighton Barnabas Coombs.
May not be joined in matrimony. Take your time. I'll repeat it again. May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Andrea Grace Lee.
To Andrea Grace Lee.
Good. Andrea, please repeat after me. And again, try and lift your voice, okay? I solemnly declare.
I solemnly declare.
That I do not know.
That I do not know.
Of any lawful impediment.
Why I, Andrea Grace Lee,
why I, Andrea Grace Lee, may not be joined in matrimony,
may not be joined in matrimony,
to Leighton Barnabas Coombs.
To Leighton Barnabas Coombs.
Very good. Do you, Leighton, agree to live with Andrea as your wife and to love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, in prosperity, or in poverty, and forsaking all others to remain faithful to Andrea alone as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Good. Andrea, I have a question for you. Do you, Andrea, agree to live with Leighton as your husband and to love him, respect him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, in prosperity or in poverty, and forsaking all others to remain faithful to Leighton alone as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Good. Who gives this woman to this man?
We do.
Very good.
Leighton and Andrea, the word I have for you is cast off. It's not in the way of something discarded, but rather it's the first command that the captain gives when he is satisfied that the ship is ready to leave the dock. And a good crew will always check the navigation of the captain. And there are a number of us on the dock here today. We've waited a while for this ship to leave this dock. And we are happy to hear that word cast off. When you both say I do to each other in a minute, so that is the point when this ship will leave the dock and begin a whole new journey, a whole new adventure. We ask God's blessing, adventure.
Well, friends and family gathered here, and friends and family around the world, welcome to this very happy occasion. Though there are some tears, I know you're very happy. On behalf of Andrea and Leighton, on behalf of Jerry and Susan, on behalf of Steve and Jan, welcome. Thank you for being here. Thank you for joining. This is a great day, and we're celebrating together. We're celebrating listening to words said, rings shared, vows made, but we're celebrating God marrying a man and a woman. It isn't my words, it isn't their words, it is God who will marry this couple together. In just a few moments, Nathan, Andrea's brother, will lead us in worship, and then Landon, a friend of both bride and groom, will be coming to share a short message. But before that, I'm going to pray. And if you're able, please will you stand and join me in prayer. Father, I thank you for this beautiful setting. I thank you that you know Leighton, you know Andrea, you know the numbers of hairs on their heads, you know the days of their lives, and you are here to bless them, to marry them together. Lord, I ask that you would open our eyes to freshly see and understand your purpose, your heart in marriage, to bring relationship, to bring comfort, to bring a display of Christ's love for the church. And the church living with Christ to your glory, that this earth will be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God. So Lord, lead us today. Lead us in worship, in your presence. And I ask, Lord, you do this by the power of your Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's worship. You'll find the words on the sheets, and sing your hearts out. Join in with the angels and Nathan.
The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. They are new every morning, new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is thy faithfulness.
We have a scripture reading.
Hello, Leighton and Andrea. Darling, this is Nanny Wiley. Just want to wish you a happy wedding day and a Bible reading. It's so sad that we can't be with you because of circumstances, but in our hearts, we'll always be with you both. And I pray that you have a loving, happy marriage. God bless you both. Lots of love, Nanny. I will now give you the reading from Colossians chapter 3. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness and humility, gentleness and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another. If any of you have any grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you were called to peace, and be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Amen.
Again, if you're listening online, most people here, well, family definitely recognize Nanny Wiley, Leighton's grandmother back in England, sharing with us. But yeah, Nanny Wiley from the UK. Let's continue in worship with Great Are You, Lord. Nathan.
Pour out our praise, pour out our praise.
Well, you may be seated. And Landon is going to come up and share.
It's an honor to be able to share, and I'm mostly going to speak to Leighton and Andrea, but speaking to all of us here as well. And yeah, this is for me at least, and maybe I'm kind of alone in this, but I highly doubt it. This has been a highly anticipated day, and I've even a few times wondered, like, are Leighton and Andrea married already? Just because I've been waiting and thinking this is so good and so right. And so since the day Leighton told me, it's just been a big yes in my heart and in Brittany's heart that this is just so good. So it's an honor to be able to share with you, and I'm going to share a few thoughts out of what has already been read out loud from Colossians 3, verse 12 and onwards. And I want to just share two aspects of this passage with you guys. The first is the fact that it's a weighty thing, what Jesus calls us to. And when I look at both of you, I can see that you guys have put a lot of effort into not only this day, but specifically how you guys look today and how you are presented. And I was with Leighton on Thursday, and he did not look like this. The beard was about down to here, and the hair was really wild and interesting. And he was not dressed like this. And I imagine, Andrea, this is not your normal attire. There's been intentionality and purpose in why you've dressed the way you have. And there will be many aspects of this wedding and of this day that you guys don't really remember. You might not even remember what you wore in many senses. But what will make a big impact on your life and on the people's lives around you is, how do you dress yourself? And do you do like this passage in Colossians says? Do you take certain things off that are so natural and so easy? And it names a few. It names selfishness, anger, bitterness, pride. These things can even be trendy and acceptable in our culture to put on and to clothe ourselves in. And yet we're called to take those things off in order to intentionally put on compassion, kindness, humility, patience, and love. Will you dress in a way to reveal and showcase what is natural and normal to yourself? Or will you dress in a way to reveal and showcase the beauty of Jesus? The world is watching. Will they see Christ Jesus in you? His goal is not simply for your happiness and that you guys would benefit one another and help one another. He has another purpose in your marriage, and it's to reveal how beautiful He is. It's good that we feel the weight, that we not rush past it. This is a high responsibility that you guys are stepping into. But it's equally as important that we know the hope that we have. It's God's plan for both of you to become more and more like Jesus. You may have heard people say something along the lines of this: that's not the man or the woman that I married. And it's often tinged with frustration, discouragement, hurt, disappointment, and even bitterness. But God's intention for you is that years down the line, you would be able to look at one another and say, he, she is not the person that I married. They've changed. They've become more like Jesus. In Corinthians, Paul says this. He says, I am what I am by the grace of God. His grace towards me has not been put to waste. This isn't new news for you guys, I know that. But it is good news. And it's worth repeating. It's worth focusing on. God's grace at work in your life will change you. Your relationship will change for the better. Like we heard Barney say, how we treat one another will change for the good. This is not the pinnacle of your relationship. There are even better days to come. Your failures are not the end of the story, but they become the backdrop of His grace. So let's feel the weight of this responsibility that Christ calls us into. Let's take it seriously, but let's also fill our hearts with the hope that is set before us. Jesus is filled with passion and faithfulness to make your marriage a place where others can see who your Heavenly Father is. And they can say they are what they are by the grace of God. His grace towards them has not been put to waste. Bless you guys.
Thank you, Landon, very much. Great words, truth. Father, watch over those words and cause them to bear fruit, not just in Leighton and Andrea, but in each one of us. Bear your fruit in us, Lord. Soften our hearts to receive your word. Thank you. Well, now, Leighton and Andrea are going to exchange vows and rings. So, would you like to pass those flowers to Katrina? Join hands. Father God, take Leighton and Andrea's words and fill them with your power, that they will with much joy make good their vows. Thank you, Lord. So, Leighton, please will you repeat after me, and remember you're talking to Andrea, not me, okay? So look at your wonderfully beautiful bride and speak loudly so these guys in other countries can hear, okay? I, Leighton.
Take you, Andrea.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
I promise before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful husband. For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and cherish and care for. As long as we both shall live. Well done. Andrea, please repeat after me and look at this man and raise your voice. I, Andrea. Take you, Leighton. To be my lawful wedded husband. You're doing great. I will repeat. I promise before God and these witnesses. Well done. To be your loving and faithful wife. For better or for worse. For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish and submit to. As long as we both shall live. Wonderful. Well, we're going to exchange rings, so maybe let go of one another's hands at this point. I know it's hard to do, but again, David, come on up. We got this very wrong yesterday. I got it right today, but Leighton just wouldn't believe me. He's been administrator in our church for a while and he's gotten to know me, so I think there's good reason why he doubted. But I got it right today. Okay. Again, I'm going to pray. Father God, as Leighton and Andrea exchange rings with one another, Andrea, I give you this ring. As the symbol and pledge. Of our constant faith. And enduring love. Okay. Tad, come on up. And Andrea. Good job, guys. Awesome. Well done. So Andrea, take take Leighton's left hand. Well done. And again, repeat after me, speaking to Leighton. Leighton, I give you this ring.
Leighton, I give you this ring.
As the symbol and pledge.
As the symbol and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And enduring love.
And enduring love.
Inasmuch as Leighton and Andrea have consented to live together and have sealed their covenant with the exchanging of vows and the giving of rings, I now declare in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit that they are husband and wife. Therefore, those whom God has joined together, let no man split asunder. Leighton, you may now kiss your bride. Cameraman may want another one.
Only if you do.
Well, while Leighton and Andrea sign the register and the license, and they're going to share communion together, Braden will lead us with some music. Enjoy, and we're just going over there.
Okay.
Don't miss me.
I'm as a professional player.
Yeah, she's for hire.
My will exalt you, God, my King. And I will praise your name forever. Great are you, Lord, in wisdom and power. Amen. You know the number of the stars. Call each of them by name. Great are you, Lord, and worthy of honor. Amen. Amen. Good is it to sing your trust in your unfailing love. Great are you, Lord, there is peace in your presence. Amen. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights above. Oh, praise him in angels all the heavenly host. Amen. 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 Let everything that can live praise Father, Son, and Holy Sanctuary in his mighty heaven. Amen. 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 Brand new song. The assembly of the saints. He crowns the humble with salvation and joy.
and everything that lives give praise. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, in the sanctuary, in His mighty heaven, amen, amen.
Yeah, right.
Not a good idea. Right?
Dad, what are these little rocks right now? Just heaven.
He loves rocks. But at the same time, he fell in love with rocks. And he also had a little call.
Well, in just a few moments, the bride and groom will join us back center stage. I have a few announcements. So after the ceremony has ended, family and wedding party. Stay here for photos. It's a superb day for photos. If it's bright sunshine, you get washed out. Clouds are good, the rain's not happening. So family and wedding party, stay here. The rest of us, we're going to go and enjoy popcorn and drinks. And Doug and Janice's, I always think of Janice here as well. Doug and Janice's lovely, wonderful garden. And you who are joining us around the world,
I don't know whether you're going to get to see the garden, but if you were to see the garden, you'd think there's a reason why it's called Beautiful British Columbia. And it might be a good reason for you to come and visit Leighton and Andrea sometime, because this is the best looking place in all the world. So just saying, okay? So family and wedding party stay here. Everyone else, popcorn back there. And another just important little announcement is, either side of the garage are two bathrooms, one on either side. They're not assigned, I don't think, to men and women, but that's just an important little room to remember.
Main left, main right.
Left as in that left. Yeah, my right. Okay, so the men closer to the house.
No.
This is why we're going through it. Ladies closer to the house, men further away from the house. Thank you, Steve. It's a good job you came.
Thank you.
Okay. Let's stand. It is with great pleasure and a privilege to be the first to introduce to you our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Leighton and Andrea Coombs. Yeah.
As the romance do, far from home, all I got is you. Every day we got a song to sing. All you need to live as a true king.
Of me.